everyone, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Samantha Anderson. I am a freelance artist and teacher hoping to inspire creativity. If you would like more videos like these, please take a second to like and subscribe down below. It really helps in the algorithm of YouTube to help get my videos seen to more people. If you want to receive notifications of when I go live, please make sure to hit the bell and choose all notifications. If you have any questions during or after the class, make sure to pop a comment down below and I will answer it as soon as I can. I'll be leaving timestamps down below so you can skip ahead to the start of class, but I will be sharing announcements as well as supplies, so make sure to stick around for that. If interested in learning more about my classes, please follow me on Facebook and Instagram, and feel free to check me out on Patreon, where I teach exclusive classes to those who support me. In Patreon, I also give traceables for all of my live classes, including this one. Lastly, if you would like to share your work after class with me and others who painted along with us, please head over to Facebook, as I have an artist community where you can share your finished painting with us. I'll leave links for all of that in the description box below. Thanks for joining me, and let's get started. Hello, hello everyone. Welcome back to another live class. I'm excited for this one. I'm always excited to paint, let's be honest. But welcome in, especially if this is your first time. Please say hello in the comments. Let me know where you are painting from. I'm excited that you're here. We're gonna go over just some housekeeping things, and then we will get started. All right, so the first thing I'm going to go over is just the supplies, and then I'll go over a few announcements once we get everything settled, and then we'll get straight to painting, okay? So the first thing I want to introduce is the traceable. Now, one of the reasons why I first started these traceables is to kind of give back to my community and those who support me. So I do have a Patreon where I give out exclusive tutorials, and within that I give out my traceables for all of my classes, including my live classes. So if you want to become a patron and support there, I would love it. You'll get behind the scenes and access to other things, and it's not just this traceable. You'll get access to every single traceable that I've ever had for my lilac tier, which is all of my free live classes. So if you want to paint with other classes as well, it's only $5, and you can, it's not like a, you know, membership where you have to commit for a certain amount of time. It's just a month, and then you can always cancel. But with that said, I will be going over a couple tips and tricks on how to draw a horse, but this isn't a horse drawing class. This is a painting class, so I will mainly be focusing on how to paint the certain elements of this class, but I'm not going to be teaching full force how to draw a horse. Again, I'll go over a couple things to get you started if you need some tips, but I would highly recommend, I am sure there are countless tutorials on YouTube with more drawing experience than even me, that can give you all the tips and tricks on how to draw horses. One thing I like to do in my classes is that if I'm going to be spending more than 15 minutes on an illustration, I try to just do a traceable myself, because I have three little kids, and while I could spend 2 hours nailing down the proportions and nailing down everything to be able to paint it, I just don't have that time. And not a lot of people do, or not a lot of people want to do that. So with that said, I do have a traceable if you are like me, or you don't want to. I have this available. It's linked, it'll be linked below after the class, but it's also linked in the live chat if you're here with me live, okay? So that's that. I'm gonna be keeping this around so I can give a couple tips, so that you guys can do that. Let me just go over the rest of the supplies, and then I'll give you a couple tips before I go over the announcements, okay? I have just my regular brushes out that I typically use for all my classes. I have a large filbert, and I typically will use this mostly for blending. And then I have a medium to small round filbert. I also have a couple round brushes. One is a little bit more rounded and then the other one is pointed. So I have both of those. And then I also have a texture brush. I also like to call this my cloud brush. It's very frayed at the top. It's just a medium to large size round brush that I use for texture, I use for dry brushing, I use for clouds. And I have that one separately for those things because doing that technique does kind of roughen up the bristles, and then it's not as nice as some of my other brushes. So I do have one specifically for that technique. And then the other one that you may or may not need, you might need some small, a small detail brush for maybe the wispy hairs or something like that. I do have a liner brush. So those are like my main brushes that I typically have in all of my classes. apologies. But yeah, so there's that. Let's go over some colors. All right, so I have my black and my white, okay? Black and white, and then you're pretty much just your yellows and your browns. I have yellow, I have brown, and then I do have a little bit of orange, and I have my red out on the side just in case I need it. I don't think I'll need it for this. I think my orange will be enough of color for that. But yeah, those are the colors that we're using. Pretty simple colors today. There's not a whole lot of varying colors, but we are gonna have fun with the just the brightness of it all. Okay, obviously I have my water, paper towel, I have a palette. Depending on how you like to mix color, I have my palette knife. I like to pre-mix colors with that, and especially if you're a beginner and you are not familiar with blending on the canvas, I would highly, highly recommend getting a flat palette where you can have a palette knife and you can pre-mix colors. One of the things that I really enjoy is using a palette knife to mix colors. I used to have one of those palettes that had little pots in it, and I would just use a small round brush to mix all my stuff. But I would waste a lot of paint in that paintbrush because then I would rinse it out and mix another color. But more importantly, I would get my water dirty before I ever even started painting. That was problematic later on when, you know, you're trying to put water in your paint for consistency and it starts changing the color. So that's also why I have two different waters, just in case I need some clean water. But yeah, I use a palette knife and I will not go back to the way I used to do it before. Also having a glass palette is really nice because it cleans really, really easy. That being said, all of the materials that I have are on my Amazon shop, which you can find linked below. I have my favorites, and then I have other suggested materials depending on your preference. So I have those available. And then lastly, I'm on a 11 by 14 canvas. So you can use a different size canvas. If you are using a traceable, I have two sizes available in there. I have 11 by 14, and then I also have a 9 by 12. If you are using a different size canvas, please just let me know and I can size it and upload it to that same post, and I will let you know there. So if you're a patron, you can just say, hey, can I do it in this size? I had a patron last month ask if they can have like a really big size, and I ended up blowing it up so big that it needed like 6 different pages. But I could do that, and then you don't have to do that work because you're supporting me and I get to do it for you. And I have the file and it's really easy. Okay. So that, I believe those are all the supplies. Let me know if you have any questions. Your colors do not need to be exactly like mine. Use what you have. Let's go ahead and go over just a couple tips for drawing this, and then I'll go over some current classes that are going on. Essentially, you want to look at the just the main horse body in two circles. So you have two circles here. You have one where the hips are, and then you have another where the shoulders are. And those are roughly the same size, okay? So those are roughly the same size. And if you put a little dot in the middle, the amount that they are apart is about the size of the radius. So that's kind of how you can get that. And then obviously you're just going to connect those. For the legs, you want to try to go directly from the middle of that, because that's where this is going to come from, where those joints are. And then everything around it just kind of connects. You see that? So this goes down. Same with this. This goes down. See how those angles connect? And then this is also another one. And again, it's the same distance. All these distances between the circles are the same distance. Sorry, I realize that I'm on the smaller one. So you have the two circles and the dot, and the radius of the dot, or the radius between the middle dot and the edge, is the length of distance between all of these circles. So that's kind of how you can get an idea of where it is. And I would highly recommend doing this on a piece of paper before you do it on the canvas, and then you can transfer it onto the canvas and go from there. And then everything else is just kind of connected, right? And honestly, it's not like, just have fun with it. Don't feel like you need to get it perfect. And honestly, I would not even worry about the feet. Don't worry about the feet. Don't worry about the hooves. The only hoof that we actually see is this one, and technically you could just cover that up. So if you're drawing this and you're like, what is happening? I cannot figure out the feet. Don't worry about the feet. It's, you can barely see them anyways, and you don't have to do that. So again, you have circle. You have circle. And this distance is the same distance to all of these circles. And that's because we're looking at the horse from a very parallel, from like the side view, okay? I'm gonna leave this up. Actually, I'm not gonna leave that up because I have to show you the other stuff. All right, so go ahead and work on that. If you have a traceable, use it. If you don't have a traceable, work on that. If you've already prepared, perfect, you're on it. I wanna go over a couple classes and what we're doing in Patreon right now. I know some of you are looking for the update of the work in progress. Oh, I forgot to post that this morning. I'll have to post that tomorrow. I usually post a work in progress of what we did yesterday, and I completely spaced, but that's okay. You guys will get to see it first, I guess. So this is the free class that we did last week. Every once a month, at near the end of the month, I will do a free watercolor class. And watercolor is not my like go-to. It's something just, I love doing watercolor. I love how it works. It's a mystery to me sometimes, and I really enjoy doing it. So I'm just here sharing my knowledge. And so we painted this little guy last week. So if you love hamsters or like animals, this was a really fun one. It's a lot simpler and easier than you might think. So if you wanna get into watercolor, I have a couple free, easy watercolors. Well, they're easy in my opinion, but I'm not super experienced with watercolor, so you get to come learn with me too. What are we doing this month? I don't remember. I picked what we did this month last month, and I don't remember what it was. But you can actually go on my YouTube and see what we're doing next. We're doing some boho abstract art. Super simple, super easy. I hope you join me. And theoretically, that one you could definitely do with acrylics too. So if you want to do it in acrylics, maybe on a big canvas, you could do a couple of them. That would go well with each other. In Patreon, I'm super excited. This class is not released yet, and I have not shown anyone, with the exception of my patrons yet. So you guys get a first sneak peek of what it is. We are doing this lovely little giraffe. And I realized after my husband was kind of pointing out that some of the colors are actually the same as what a giraffe might be. It's not as abstract as I hoped it would be, but looking at, if you've been around for a little bit, you'll know that we also did an elephant and we did a lion in these same colors. And for the elephant and lion, it was more obvious that the colors were different, but because a giraffe is yellow, the colors are very close to what a giraffe would be. They're just a little bit more saturated. But they all match and it's really fun. So our next one is going to be a rhino, and I'm really excited because then we'll have like a four piece like set of these like abstract African animals, which makes me really excited. So we're almost done with that, but this is in Patreon. So this is an exclusive. All three of these so far have been in Patreon. They're exclusive to patrons. It's at the $10 level. So if you want to join, now is kind of a really good time because it's the beginning of the month. You'll have all month to do to paint with as many tutorials as you want, because you also get access to all my past tutorials as well. It's not just one tutorial. You get access to all of them, which is a really cool perk. And then in the $20 tier, we have been working on this guy. And I don't know if you noticed, but we didn't paint last week because I thought I might have jury duty and I didn't want to cancel classes. So I just had the week off doing admin and stuff like that. But we finished everything with the exception of the turtle. And I'm so excited to start the turtle next week. So this time around, we added a couple more fish. We finished all the coral over here and I am in love. So I hope you'll follow along with me. My Facebook hasn't even seen this yet because I blanked on posting it. But if you are not over there on Facebook, please make sure you go over there. I'll post a link for that right now. That is where I post the majority of my content. It's overwhelming. Like I pretty much post every day, sometimes twice. And it's about classes going on, work in progresses, things coming up, classes coming up, schedules and things like that. So if you like that sort of information, please go follow me on my Facebook, because that is the place to be. Okay. If nobody has any questions, we can go ahead and get started on this painting. Let's go ahead and get started. Grab some water first. Sometimes when I talk a lot, my throat gets all dry. Okay. Yay. All right, let me know if you have any questions. And that's like throughout the class, because most likely if you have a question, somebody else might have the same question. So we are going to be going over our silhouette first. Now, if you don't have it drawn on and you're gonna just paint it on, that's okay too. You'll just do that afterwards. So, you could do it now, but I would say if you don't have something to like essentially color in, then I would suggest to, just to wait until you're done with the background and then put in your horses. But since we are using the traceable, and or you drew it on, we're gonna go ahead and there's two ways to do this. You can color in the whole thing, and then we'll do the background, and then you can just fill in the little pieces that you went over, or you can outline it. So it's up to you. I find that outlining, sometimes the lines can get lost a little bit. So I like to just full on put in all of the black first and then let that dry while we come up with all of our colors, and then I go from there. So that's what I will be doing today. I'm gonna start with the horses and then do the bottom, because while I'm doing the details of the horses, I don't want to stick my hand in the bottom of the black. And that'll also give the horses more time to dry while we're doing this, because we really do want the horses to be fully dry before we go move on to our background. And I know it's a little backwards. A lot of times you do the background first and then that, but because they're silhouettes, it makes it really easy just to put in the black and then fix the black later if needed. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and take one of my smaller round brushes, and I'm not gonna worry about the hair. That's one thing that you don't need to worry about, is the hair. Don't do the hair yet. Don't do the tail. I mean, you can put in like roughly where it is, maybe where it comes out of the back, but I don't think that you should put in the little strands of hair. You can do that afterwards. So I'm just gonna start here at the top. Every time I'm drawing or painting horses, I always like wonder, does anybody ever wonder like how such a large animal, how such a large strong animal can have such tiny little legs? Just me? If anyone has any questions about Patreon or YouTube or anything like that, now's the time to ask me, because this portion of the class is very straightforward. You don't really need, I mean, if you have any questions, feel free to ask it, but this part is very straightforward. I don't feel like I really need to tell you how to color in the lines. And I'm not even gonna worry about putting in the feet, if I'm at all honest, because I'm just gonna cover it up with black anyways. And the one thing that I am making sure of is that this first coat of black is flat, so there's no like there's no big parts of like clumps of paint or anything like that in it, because we don't want big clumps. And if at any point you get black outside of where you wanted it, just take a clean brush with a little bit of water and just pull in to wherever your black should be, and that will just kind of wipe it off. It's a really easy way of kind of erasing the paint that you had. Oh, I didn't see. Hello from Tennessee. Hello from Louisiana. Hello from Iowa. Hello. Got people coming in from all over. All right. All right, so I'm gonna do a little bit of the tail, but I'm not gonna do the little ends of the wispy parts. And this particular horse, their hair is like shorter and less long, I guess you could say. So I'm okay with doing the top part because it's a little bit more clumpy. It's not as wispy. But on the next one, I'm probably not going to touch the hair until I actually start painting it. Or until after our background's done. Hi, Kat. No worries. We are filling in our horses. At the beginning, I gave a couple tips on how to draw it, but for the most part, we're just focusing on painting today. So if you want a traceable, it's available in my Patreon. If you don't, you want to draw it, that's totally fine. You can always, if you end up being a little bit behind or whatever, you can always rewatch it. I don't take down my classes. And you can always come back and finish the class. So we're almost done. At least I'm almost done. Alright, so that is pretty much all I'm going to do for the horses themselves. Now I'm going to rinse out my brush. I'm going to make sure there's no clumps of paint. Make sure it's all smooth. And looks like that is good. All right, so now I'm going to go to a bigger brush. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to start at the bottom. Because I always forget the bottom, let's be real. Not always, but there are many times where I've just forgotten to do the bottom. What's nice is it's just all black, so I don't have to worry about coming back and kind of painting it as I go. I can just paint it now and be done. Right, so the first thing I'm going to do after getting that initial black on is I'm gonna kind of try to figure out where this initial line is. And I'm going to go ahead and put in where that, like, reflection is and kind of paint around it a little bit, just ever so slightly. We can always put in other parts. And it's up to you whether or not you want to put in the white over the black or the black over the white. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put mainly all of this black with the exception of like the main parts. And then I'll come back over it with black. I'm gonna do something fun, and I'm gonna use the texture of the, I'm gonna see if this works, and if not, we can totally just like paint over it and it'll be fine. But I'm gonna use the texture of the canvas to kind of like do the work for me. So I'm painting on this canvas, and I'm painting it with a dry brush. Now what I mean with is I don't have like any water on my brush. It's just the paint. So you'll see when I go across this, you see all that? All those dots? See what it's doing? It's creating a bunch of black dots for me, and I don't even have to do anything. So I'm using like the full brunt of my brush. With just a little bit of paint on there. And in some places I can add a little bit more paint. I'm using just the tip of my brush to add certain elements of this. I'm actually like loving this technique. And then when we go over with the yellow, we'll be able just to add that color in there. And then we'll add it anywhere else. Alright, so I think I'm going to leave that for now. And we'll play with this. It's already turning out so pretty. Okay, so hopefully this is pretty much, my horses are pretty much dry. I didn't get any paint on me when I just did that, so that's great. Let's go ahead and mix together our yellows, and that'll give time for the rest of this to dry. Actually, I want to do a little bit more. Okay, so let's see. Oh, I'm actually seeing now that I'm actually looking at it, there is a touch of blue in the water, like in this part of the water. So maybe grab a blue for later. For now, let's go ahead and mix together a couple different colors of our yellow. Now you'd be surprised at how much of this is actually, so you are gonna need a good amount of white on your palette. Can you believe that the only color we've used so far is black? And it's already like, like our whole composition is there. That's one thing I love about, sunset silhouettes, because there's always so much color and yet it's very simple in terms of, you know, how to do it. And here's an example of, I felt like I drew on his nose just a little bit too long, so I didn't go out as far as my pencil markings was. So I'm actually, now that this is dry, I'm just erasing any pencil marks that I don't want. And that's pretty much it. I don't think I have any other ones that I didn't cover up. But yeah, you can do that. You can just erase it. Alright, I have my white, and I'm just going to put a couple white dots over here, because I know I'm going to use that much yellow, I mean that much white. I have yellow, I'm going to get out a tiny bit of orange. And then a little bit of brown as well, because that's gonna tone down the colors and make them look a little bit more realistic. Okay, let's see. Oop, where are you on? Okay, I'm gonna grab my palette knife, and we're going to first do kind of just the main yellow in here. Now, something to take note about is that a lot of the time when you're mixing color off canvas, sorry, this is like really bright. I don't know why this is so bright. When you're mixing colors off of canvas, like on your palette, you have to make sure that you do a little dollop somewhere on your canvas before you start painting the whole thing, because a lot of the time, especially with beginners, is that it looks way different on the canvas or on the palette than it does on the canvas, and you really have to make sure that the color that you're wanting to use really is the color that you're wanting to use. So I'm gonna go ahead and mix this one, and I'm gonna mix some yellow. I'm gonna do just yellow first. And now I'm going to tint it with a little bit of orange, and orange kind of can take over, so make sure you're just using a tad bit to start with. And now I'm going to use a tiny bit of brown, just to tone down the color a little bit. Now it's kind of like this warm golden. I'm going to do even more orange. Okay, so I'm thinking that even though this color, I'm thinking it's for here, it's probably too bright for that. So I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit over here on the side. Yeah, I think a little bit more orange and it would be as dark as this. It's a little bit too bright. So I'm gonna grab some more brown, a little bit of orange, and just keep mixing. And at this point, it's darkened up a lot. So I'm gonna take just a little bit of this and mix it with the white that's right next to it. And this seems like it'd be a really good color for the sky. I'm going to take some of this yellow, add a little bit more orange and brown to it over here. So I have a little bit of a darker kind of orangey brown to put over here. And these colors don't have to be exact. I really enjoy trying to get the colors that I see, not the colors I think I see. And it's a really great exercise, to be honest. It's a really great exercise. But I understand that it is really hard to do that. So if you are not a fan of doing that, just do it as the best as you can. I would ask that you challenge yourself if that's really, if you want to get better at it. And do what I just did. Just figure out, put it on the canvas and see what it actually looks like so that you can adjust from there. But yeah, let's go ahead. We're going to start off. Let me clean my big brush because that's the one we're starting with. Try not to look at the clouds so much and the different parts of the clouds. Just focus on the main colors. We can always come back and add little bits and pieces to make it look like clouds and lighting, different things. So don't worry about that. Just focus on the main colors right now, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and put some white in the middle here after I take the paint off my palette knife. I'm gonna put some white here in the middle, and right where this thing is, right where like the end of the tail is, that's where the brightest part is. And And I'm taking that white outside of where I think it will be. Because now I'm going to go into this yellow. And I'm going to blend it in. And I'm just going to kind of pull it into that white space. Maybe get a little bit of my darker yellow and just pull it in. I'm just going to kind of play with it while it's all wet. You can still play with it. Now I'm going to go back into my, this is my lightest yellow color. Can you believe that? It looks so dark on the canvas, but it's not. And I'm just making sure that I am going over my silhouettes. I'm going to start adding those darker colors. This is my medium color. I had to double check because I thought, I was like, oh my gosh, did I get the darkest color? I'm like, nope, I didn't. And I can tell already that it's not as orange as I feel like it should be. So I'm going to go in with a little bit of my orange that I mixed in with it just now. I'm just going to blend that back and forth. Whenever you're blending back into a color, make sure you dip your paintbrush in that color that you're trying to blend into, and that will help the transition. And I realized I went over where the C should be. So just so it's not harder to go over later, I'm gonna go ahead and just get a clean brush and take off the orange where the C should be. sides. And it looks a lot more yellow on the screen than it does in person. So I'm kind of sad about that because it looks a lot more closer to the colors that I'm seeing on the picture, on the photo. So here, maybe I'll change the camera a little bit. That's closer to what I see. Yeah, that's better. Okay, so we're just going to trudge along. Now, if you want to, you can create almost like a gray orange for these top clouds by adding a little bit of black and white to your kind of orangey one. Give me a second, my son is knocking at my door right now. So just go ahead and blend that all the way across. Give me 1 second. Apologies. My daughter's having having quiet time in my son's room, and my daughter says she wants to be alone. So my son's like, where do I go? Okay, so let's keep going on this. Thank you. So the clouds, obviously, they don't have to be the same. We're gonna go ahead and add a little bit of different clouds in here with our cloud brush, at least the one that I have. So I'm gonna take, I'm gonna take, essentially wherever you are, you'll have to add like a darker version of that. So I'm just gonna add this darker one here. I have like my medium yellow color. And I come in with a little bit of a darker one here. And I'm honestly just placing my brush down and wiggling it as I like go out. I'm not being like, it's, for me, it's more about just getting texture in the sky and less about like, a lot of times just getting a little bit on there, your brain will do the rest. I'm going to switch to a smaller brush and grab some white. And do the same thing, pull those colors out. You can put some yellow back here and create some clouds back here. But it's like, honestly, like it looks like clouds, but if you zoom in, it's really just like blotches of paint. That's the trick with clouds, is that it's like rarely are you actually like drawing a cloud. You're just kind of putting paint in such a way that it gives the illusion that there are clouds. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and grab my small filbert and starting with a very, very dark brown. So I have mostly brown with black. I should say mostly black with a little bit of brown. And if you want to, if you're not good at straight lines, then you can grab some tape and you can just put it across wherever you want your line to be. I think that's straight. Maybe not. Is that straight? Let's see. When in doubt, use a ruler. Yeah, it's close enough. Alright. So I'm just gonna use this as a way to gauge that line. I'm gonna start off with a very dark black brown, and then as I move in, I'm gonna slowly start adding one of my yellows. And that line is going to start a little bit, that light part is going to start a little bit closer to this edge than it is that one, because it's closer, the sun is closer to that side, at least in this. Take this yellow, put it right here in the middle. Now my paint is like doing weird things right now because it's like half dried and half not, so I'm gonna have to wait till this dries to continue, but that is okay. I am pretty much done with the sky, so I'm going to use the time, that time for my mountains to dry, to put on an extra coat of black, and I'm also going to put in a coat of yellow here. So I'm going to do that first and show you how to do it. You're going to put on what's called a wash. So get a very clean brush. I'm going to rinse this out in my dirty water and then rinse it out in my clean water. I'm going to grab some of this water and I'm going to get my lightest yellow first. I'm just going to put on a coat of yellow. And you can see that it didn't make enough of a difference, so I'm going to put on a slightly darker version. And we'll come back over this with our black. We're just trying to get that color in there. And in the bodies of the water, you could be a little bit more, you can put in a little bit more color. If I would have thought about this technique before I would have colored the black, I would have put the yellow on before, and then we could have just put the black over and it would have been great. But this is also fine. Okay, so while all that dries, we're going to go over our, I'm gonna go over my horses again. And I know that putting in this second coat of black will really help. All right, since this is the second coat and we are finished with the background, I'm gonna go ahead and grab my liner brush, grab some black. Make sure you add some water to that so that it can flow freely. And anywhere where you feel like there needs to be a little bit of hair, and I'm going back after maybe every 10 hairs. And you notice that I didn't redo the legs yet because I want to finish the bottom. I want to finish the, I want to finish the mountains first. If you are new to the channel, I would really love it if you subscribed and made sure that you liked this video, because it really does help in the, you know, search algorithm of YouTube, as well as I am attempting to get to 10,000 subscribers by the end of the year. So if you would like to help with that and you like the content, please make sure to subscribe, and then share with your friends, share with your painting friends. I do live classes every single week, so there's always something to share. So I'm going to switch over to my liner brush. There's that. And then I'm just going to do one more. If your paint isn't flowing enough, try to add a little bit of water. Now that we're done with that, I'm going to go ahead and put one more coat on the mountains. Which I think will be better. So I'm going from pretty much my yellow to my brown and then to black. So now that we have done those, I'm going to go ahead and take off the tape. I'm not going to do the legs of the horse until after I'm done with both the water and the mountains, so essentially the water. So let's go ahead and put together our water first. I am going to lay down a coat of yellow because I realize that once we get on this yellow, we can just put down our blue over the dry yellow and that will work fantastic. As we get to this area, we're definitely going to lighten it up a little bit. And put in some darker yellows over here. Essentially, we're just matching what's on the top right above it. So now we're going to get out some blue. And first I need to kind of make some space. So I'm going to put some water. Over here and just create some space for myself. This is one of the most satisfying things I do while I paint is cleaning off my palette, especially during class. It's so easy, so quick. All right, so I have a little bit of blue and I'm going to make like a blue gray. So what I'm going to do is I have my ultramarine blue. I'm going to mix some white and gray and a little bit of blue. And actually this is phthalo blue, I realized. I think I even need some more white and maybe even some yellow because it is very close to the color that's already on there. And I'm calling it blue, but maybe it's actually green. I don't know. I'm gonna do a little dollop and see if it's the color that I want. I'm gonna do it over here. I think that's pretty close. I'm going to add a little bit more black to it just to make it ever so slightly darker and even more gray. All So the blue that we're seeing, the water is the reflection that we're seeing that's yellow is reflecting the sun and that sky, and then the other stuff that we're seeing is reflecting the sky that's like up and behind us, the stuff that's blue. So that's why it's reflecting two separate colors. I think it needs to be even darker. Now that I'm putting more of it on there, it needs to be a little bit darker even so. Just so I know where to not put my blue, I'm gonna go ahead and take this and add some white right here, because that's where I'm gonna add just a tiny bit of brown to this blue because I'm feeling like it's a little bit too blue and it needs to be like browned up. I don't know how to say that. Like muddied a little bit. Like it's too vibrantly blue, which is funny because it looks almost gray here. But when I put it on there, it's definitely blue. And I'm just continuing to add that blue color in little strips and streaks, allowing the canvas to take texture when it wants. So like there's a ton of texture over here. I'm just doing, it's pretty much a dry brush effect. right. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and add the legs to my horse, my horses. Have a little bit more. We're almost done. So now that I got that second coat out of the way, I do want to make sure that this black, this last coat is all black. Alright, so now we can get back with our large brush and black and fix any bottom parts that we feel like need to be reinforced with our black. I'm going to go ahead with a bright yellow. And put it around the almost to give like a glow around the yellow, the white, like sun reflections. I'm also going to come in here with a toothbrush, and let's see what color, probably the yellowish orange color. And I'm going to splash all the bottom, and then I'm going to take a large brush that is clean, a dry, clean brush, and I'm just going to brush it across. We'll do it a little bit more gently this time so I don't And essentially now you can add any other details that you want. If you want to add more yellow or more white or anything like that, you can go ahead and add those now, just like with lines or dots. But yeah, that is pretty much it. That is the end of class. Thank you so much for joining me. I really enjoyed this. If you are interested in other classes, please make sure to check out my YouTube. I have a ton of free classes as well as new classes each week. So make sure to go over there. If you painted this with me, whether or not live or you're rewatching this at a later date, I just posted my Facebook group. Please go over there, find the album that is this class, and you can add yours to that album. Yeah, I have every single class that I've ever done online, whether in Patreon or YouTube, in there as an album, and you can see everybody else who has joined that class. Not everybody adds theirs to the album, so sometimes it's just mine, because they'll just post it on the wall, which is totally fine. You could do that, but if you want it to be in the album for others to see, make sure you go to the album itself. If it's close to the class, you can also see it at, in the pinned featured section, so you can click on that. But yeah, thank you so much for joining me. Again, please like and share, subscribe if you're not subscribed, and make sure to go over to my Facebook and follow me there, because that is where I post 95% of all my content is over there. So yeah, we will see you next class. I'm super excited for our next class, and yeah, we're going to be painting, a butterfly, an orange butterfly sitting on a orange flower. It's going to be pretty simple concept, but if you like painting butterflies or flowers, I hope that you will join us for that one, okay? We will see you next week. Thank you so much for joining me, and we'll see you then. Bye, guys.